Hello, Mark. We're going through an epic one today. So we're going to be flying from Alaman. We're going to head over Sellafield, up to Keswick, over Grasmere, along Lake Windermere to Bowness. We're going to cut across to Kendal. We're going to head back over to Green River Sands. Then we're going to go to Morecambe. Gonna go to Hard Lancaster in, and then all the way down to Blackpool, check out the Blackpool Tower, straight over to Southport, through Southport, all the way down, check out Goodison Park and Anfield, and then we're gonna land at John Lennon Airport, Liverpool. So we'll get straight into it, guys. It's a decent sized flight, this one. Try and get it a bit as quick as possible. I've changed the weather to a nice clear day for us. So we've got fuel showing up 100% again. I don't know why. It does not like me changing the fuel. Obviously, we're going for a lighter fuel load. 50% should be more than enough. Journey. Right, guys, without further ado, let's get up in the air. We are away on our destination. So, obviously the first place we're going to is Sellafield. So it's just time to relax and enjoy this section of flight, guys. we're nice and climbing up to the correct altitude. Drop the revs down just a little bit. So let's have a look at the maps and see what we've got to look forward to, guys, on this flight today. So as you know, we've now covered off the whole of Alaman, Northern Ireland. We are over 23 or 24 weeks now of these flights, believe it or not. We've been doing it for quite some time, and I've enjoyed every minute of it. So the first protocol will be the Sellafield nuclear power plant and the Windscale advanced gas cooled reactor. And then we'll be making a turn from there. It's just slightly north. Hopefully the flight will be fairly smooth. Once you've got the nav on and autopilot, it does make it a lot simpler to fly. That is for sure. So this flight, it's quite a fair bit to see. So we've got, as we make our way down to Liverpool, passing Blackpool. And then after that, what I might do is make a hop over to Manchester just so you can see Old Trafford. And then we are going to Wales. I'm going to go all the way around the coast of Wales. So it's going to be a fairly long one, that, so I might do it all in one day. I don't know. Not decided. Still, I'll think about that one. Playing over to the right for some map. There's the Isle of Man in the distance, as you can see. That's not what that plane is. There's a plane just to the right. Don't see it at all. But it is following the same track as us, pretty much. We are going to meet okay, so we're halfway across the sea here. this is a more relaxed pace, this bit, till we start talking about everything coming up. I'm still in amazement that I've made it this far around. Where I started in pretty much at Tattershall, RAF Coningsby, where we started this journey. We're flying a very much smaller plane than this. I've moved up to a bigger plane. Looking around, I don't see that other plane anywhere. It does look like he's heading for Sellafield. I've got to say, I think he's slightly ahead of us. But I've got a slightly raised altitude just because we are heading to something else. I don't see. Maybe that person is or where they are. Just there ahead of me at the moment. You notice my fuel's gone back to 100% again. I'm going to reduce it to 50. That's what it changes it back again. Okay, so every other person is pretty much just going over Sellafield now. Potentially could be somewhere in a fast jet, they're going faster than we're going anyway. Okay guys, so the first place we've gone up to is Sellafield. So 10 kilometres away. I'm going to pan around and show you the other man. It's way within the distance now. Okay, so now we're going over Sellafield Nuclear Power Plant. Big site that is. It's huge, you know, because our big places to fly. I've driven past it before. On the road. I never really noticed just how big the actual place is. actually quite in big sight. Hey guys, that's the turn made. See, I don't really want to skim too much lower on the height, just because we're going up in the mountains if I do. Or hills. This is a bit of a cross-country trek till we get to next point before we turn and head down to Windermere. So anybody that's climbed any of these peaks, let us know in the comments. Now, I've been to Lake District probably about 6 times total. Stayed at different places. The last place we stayed at was Greystoke Forest. And there's Cleator and Penadell. I thought I'd see more live players actually doing the Mac Loop. So I might drop the altitude down just a tad, make it more fun. See lots of lakes here. Absolutely beautiful scenery. If you know the area, then you know. If you know, you know. Buttermere, I've done before. And this road here, also been down, Newlands. Well, fuel's gone back up to 100% again. no idea. I don't know what's going off there. Why does it? So, yeah, next place, guys, is Keswick. And we're going to make a turn and head to Windermere. So, beautiful town of Keswick. Been here a couple of times. It's an absolutely brilliant park for the kids with the BMX track. Keswick. Definitely highly recommend it. Here we go, it's worth a view. It's a beautiful place. BMX park was down there in the town. Down there the river winds its way around. See, guys, now we're gonna go away down to Windermere. Absolutely beautiful scene, right? That little island there, it's called Halls Owl Island. There we are. Christian and Nugget Niggy View. Situation here, isn't it? As you can see, the Lake District has many lakes. This below us there is Wyburn Church, right on the edge of the lake. Just below us there. Now we are heading to Lake Windermere, which is one of the big lakes here. You will see, maybe see Ray Castle on the right hand side. Grassmere. Again, another little beautiful place Grassmere is. So, yeah, some of you may know that that is Ambleside, the town of Ambleside, which is right at the other end of Lake Windermere. We are going to come across this castle. So Ambleside's also a beautiful little town. grey castles down there on the right there. I'm just about to see the castle. It's showing you the castle. Like some sort of structure anyway. But that is the castle. It's really the castle. So now we're going up to the town of Donuts. Straight ahead of us. I'll see you off campsite. It's got all the way down here. It's very popular. There we go now, guys. Get your foot up town. This is where you do all your boating trips from. Go out onto the lake. Okay, we'll make our next turn now. It perfect, nice big turn. I think I'll bring that two down just a little bit more for you to enjoy. Down a bit, guys. It's, you know, it's worth enjoying these places at a slightly reduced altitude. Well, this will be fairly short, and I'm returning again. Good view around. There's Windermere in the background and bonus. And I'll say goodbye too. Underbarren Barryfield. So the right of us there. The barrow is there. That's Kendall. There we go. So you get a good look at the beautiful town of Kendall, where you can buy Kendall mint cake. If you've never tried it, maybe you would like to. It's not for me, but some people really like it. I'm not a fan of it personally. There you go, a little flyover. Now don't get me wrong, I love mint, and I love cake, but mint cake's just like a sugar block with mint tasting, so yeah, it's not really for me, guys. Alright. Say goodbye to Kendall. So we're going to head along coast here, then we're going to make a turn and go over to Morecambe, which is obviously famous for What, Morecambe? Anyone know? That's right. Eric Morecambe. There's a big statue of Eric Morecambe in Morecambe itself. Is it famous for Morecambe Football Club? No, I don't think so. Is it famous for Morecambe Promenade? Maybe it was at one time. But we'll fly over and we'll see. Before we get to that, guys, we're going to Grange over Sands. It's the next port of call. I'm getting a lot of screen tears tonight, guys. What's up now? This part of England is absolutely beautiful, I'll say. But this side in Barrow and Furness I've never been to. Actually never been to Warwick or even Glass. Oh, maybe I've been to even Glass, that's where the railway is. Actually, I think I have actually been to Ravenglass, but I've never been to Scaffold Peak, which is over to the right. It's over there. Probably should check it out, but never mind. Carry on. The route I've selected. Right, so it's Grange over Sands. Small town. But worth seeing. Let's go to fly over it, making a turn. The next stop, guys, is Morecambe. I believe that is what I selected. It will be a case of going to Morecambe. And then I think we're heading Lancaster from Morecambe. Okay, guys. So here comes Morecambe. I have been to Morecambe. I've been to Morecambe and I've had fish and chips and I've seen the Eric Morecambe statue. That's what I know about it. I'm not 100% sure where I had it, but I know I had it on the beach right here somewhere. See, it's quite big. Quite a big place indeed. And then straight over to Lancaster. A very short hop this one, guys. Plane below us or above us somewhere. I'm not sure where. There's Lancaster, which is absolutely huge as well. Lancaster is somewhere that I've been to many, many times, as I used to have to come here for work. Into the centre of Lancaster. That's one place I do know. Okay, look at the moon, look. How real that looks. Now guys, we're on our way to Blackpool. Blackpool Tower is our next destination. So it is quite a short flight. 27 kilometres, and not far at all. Didn't even see that other plane. Let's go by Lancaster. There's Glasson. That's an interesting looking place, Glasson. So that's a harbour or? It's like a canal network. Glasson. Interesting. It's got a cavern site not far away as well. Let's have a look and see what Glasson is. It's the Glasson Dock. A few houses there. Car park. Yeah, got a dock here in Marina. Interesting. interesting indeed. I never knew about that. It's just a place that I never knew about. Plane is absolutely flying beautifully. Mind you, that everything's clear, so it will do. It's following the route perfectly. I can't fault it tonight. Right, so this state pool. You may notice the caravan site there. Small caravan site. Not sure what caravan site that is. There's a couple around. I noticed as we're flying over. But then we are getting more towards Blackpool now, so Fleetwood's over there in that corner, if you're wondering. We're kind of going over style mine there, and as you can see, you've got lots of caravan sites here as we start heading down the east coast of England. Sorry, west coast of England. I'm so used to saying east coast. And it also gets a lot busier with everything, really, buildings. Lots of buildings. See if we can bring our altitude down a little bit more. Yeah, that's 2,500. Alright, on. Alright guys, we're about to come over Blackpool Tower now. Bring it down a bit because I want to show you Blackpool Tower. There she goes. What a sight Blackpool Tower is, I swear. A mini Eiffel Tower. Look, Blackpool Tower is everyone, if you're wondering. A mini Eiffel. Guys, Right, so we're going to carry along the coast now, guys. So that's Blackpool Tower, as you can see. She's still there, prominent. All the way along the coast here. Now, try and keep the altitude quite low. There's the airport of Blackpool. But we won't be landing there, guys, because we are going to Liverpool. I just want to check some of the guys, because I don't think someone can check on here right now. That runway wasn't very clear at all. Right, guys, that's an interesting little black strip over there. Hey, St. Anne's and Sea. Next we're off to Goodison Park, and then Anfield, to show you both the stadiums. Hopefully it won't be ruined by the cloud. Get rid of the cloud. Get rid of the cloud, make it totally clear for us. It certainly won't be taking as long, guys, till we actually land in ourselves, so we'll do this flight over Goodison Park and Anfield, and then I'll immediately set up a landing. So here's our first port call, which is Southport. There's an airport just to the right there, as you can see. Be prepared, the airport at John Lennon will revisit. No doubt about it. That sun's very bright. No, I might put the real weather back on just as we get to the airport, just for a laugh. So here's Barton. The Microlite Club to the right. Inzbundel Microlite. Won't be under there. Now I'm going to need to move my position soon for landing. That's what I can potentially do now. Yeah, I can wrangle up again. There we go, find it easier from that angle. Okay, you can see Goodison Park ahead of us now. So let's keep his eyes peeled here, guys, because we've got Goodison Park and Anfield as well. And anyone that's watching this, it's not sure about football. Can you tell me who plays at Goodison Park? Yeah, that's right, it's Everton. And then Anfield is Liverpool, as you already know. Okay guys, we are getting very close to the two stadiums. And also getting close to where we have to start talking to air traffic control and consider our landing options. So we are now in Liverpool, and you can see Liverpool is huge. Liverpool docks is over there, which is also huge. Massive dock area, it was. And then we've got Goodison Park. Oh, it's terraced houses around it. There we go. EFC, Everton Football Club. And then you have Anfield, which is not far away from it. So two of Britain's biggest football clubs are pretty much next door to each other. Hey guys, now that's done. We have got to talk to air traffic control and get this landing sorted. This is perfect for us guys. Absolutely perfect. You fancy I'll put real weather on for a laugh? Oh my god, that's horrendous. You know why, don't you guys? I bet it's snowing here. Should we do it anyway? Because it's live. Yeah, I'm filming this, guys, in the winter. It's either foggy or it's snowing. I think what I'm going to do, guys, I'm going to put it on not live weather because I want to see the runway. I want to see the airport. Some sort of cursor on my screen now. Went there before. Should be a pretty smooth landing, guys. I'm hoping anyway. Oh, the rendering's absolutely shocking today. I don't know what's going on with the game. That's it, guys, we're down. So that was a plane landing. Let's have a look at this plane that's landing. You know, I was almost sure I saw playing this guy just coming in. Here we are, guys, big airport. Lots of planes in this airport terminal. Oh, there's the plane landing, look. That is it, guys. We have done. Engines are off and we have made it. So, I want to say a big thank you if you've watched all of it. I appreciate it's been another long flight. And we'll be back again soon with the next part. And let's just have a quick look and see what the live weather looks like right now. Yeah, it's just full fog. I would actually see nothing if I was doing it in this now. It's extremely foggy. Let's switch it off. So has the plane taken off or? Well, if that's the same plane. No, that's the same plane from earlier that landed. So yeah, that's it everyone. Thank you very much for watching and we'll see you again soon. Bye for now.